Good morning, Crosspoint kids. So happy to be with you this morning. Why don't you get on your feet? Rachel and Trey are going to lead us in worship again this morning. Let's start dancing and giving God some praise.
At break of day, in hope we rise. We speak your name, we lift our eyes. Tune our hearts into your beat. Where we walk, there you'll be. With fire in our eyes, our lives alight. Your love untamed, it's blazing out. The streets will glow forever bright. Your glory's breaking through the night. You will never fade away. Your love is here to stay. By my side in my life, shining through me every day. You will never fade away. Your love is here to stay. By my side in my life, shining through me every day.
Thank you. kids, will you please pray, I had them pray with me. Thank you, Jesus, for this day, and thank you for just creating us so that way we can worship you. And dear Jesus, thank you for everything that you do for us, and please bless this day, and thank you for watching over us, and thank you that we can go to church and worship you, even if it's online, or even if we just go to church and do it. In Jesus' name, amen.
Hey, Crosspoint kids. Hope you're having a great day today. I'm out here on the church grounds doing some bird watching. Oh! Thought I saw a flamingo. I'm out here on the church grounds doing some bird watching, and these binoculars are really coming in handy. You see, binoculars, they help you take a closer look at things that are far away. Things like birds, and if you're at a sporting event, they can help you see some of the players up close. You know, there's other things we use like telescopes and microscopes to see outer space and things that in science, like little things in a dish that we need to take a closer look at. And those things are awesome. But sometimes we need to take a closer look at something that a binoculars and a telescope and a microscope doesn't help us with. And what I'm talking about is faith. Throughout the month of June and July, we're going to be talking about how we take a closer look at faith, which is something that we can't always easily see with our own two eyes. So we need to figure out other ways to develop a deeper understanding of our faith and really dive into what it means to take a closer look at that. I'm really enjoying it out here, but why don't we head inside and talk more about our lesson this week? Okay, Crosspoint kids, thanks for joining me outside to do some bird watching this morning. But I'm so glad to be back in here with you. I can't wait until this room is full of Crosspoint kids and leaders and we're all together in person worshiping together. But in the meantime, so happy to continue bringing you the lessons here each week, and I hope that you're all doing so well. So, again, this month, we're going to be talking about faith. And in fact, we're going to be talking about faith not only this month, but next month as well. So buckle up. I hope that you're ready to learn about this topic and just dig into what it means to have faith, okay? So we are defining faith as trusting in what you can't see because of what you can see. And our theme is focus, take a closer look. So as we mentioned, faith is one of those things that we can't see it. We can't use the tools that we have at our disposal to usually have a closer look at something, such as a pair of binoculars or a telescope. But we are going to be focusing on some tools that God does give us to take a closer look at what it means to have faith, okay? Before we get there, let's take a look at what our memory verse is this month.
Our memory verse this week is, faith is being sure of what we hope for. It is being sure of what we do not see. Hebrews 11:1.
Such a great memory verse, right? What I love about this memory verse is it's almost like a second definition of faith for us this month, right? It says, faith is being sure of what we hope for. It is being sure of what we do not see. Now, the very next verse after this, Hebrews 11:2, says, this is what the people of the past were praised for. You see, God doesn't give us binoculars to see him. He doesn't give us a telescope to see him. But he does give us something. He gives us this. He gives us the Bible. He gives us these words that we can lean on and trust and know are the truth to get to the root of who he is and understand who he is better. And that's exactly what people like Abraham and David and Moses did. And we're going to start off our lesson plan this month by learning about those people in the book of Hebrews, chapters 11 and 12. So go ahead and open up your Bibles, and we're going to look at the lesson video today to learn more about what these early Christians did in order to have faith in God.
Inspired by the book of Hebrews, chapters 11 and 12.
Gotta have a little faith, 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 faith. Keep the faith. Take a leap of faith. You know, a lot of people toss around the word faith lately. We say you can break the faith or just take it all on blind faith. But true faith isn't blind at all. It's much more than just an inspirational word. True faith has to do with believing in all the things you can't see because you start with what you can see. Now, we can't see God with our physical eyes, but we can see the stories of people who came before us. They lived in a broken world like we do, but they chose to follow God. They chose to trust His promise that one day He would send a rescuer that would make everything right again. The writer of Hebrews in the New Testament tells us about some of these men and women in God's story. People like Noah, people like Abraham.
Abraham.
When God called Abraham, he was already getting old. He and his wife Sarah didn't have kids.
Leave your country and your people. Leave your father's family. Go to the land I will show you. All nations on earth will be blessed because of you.
God was planning on sending his rescuer as one of Abraham's great, 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 etc. grandchildren. But still, even though Abraham had God's promise, he still couldn't see the one God was sending. Still, Abraham went on a wild adventure, following God's call. And even his descendants, Isaac, Jacob, and Joseph, all chose faith in God. Moses, too, was called by God from the fiery heart of a burning bush. Even though he was raised by Pharaoh's daughter, he chose to stand with his own people and face Pharaoh's anger to win freedom. We read about it like this in the book of Hebrews.
Moses suffered shame because of Christ. He thought it of great value.
See, when you check out Hebrews, you discover this huge list of people who followed God by faith. So many that the writer just stops trying to list all of them. Oh, but we can't forget Israel's most important king, David.
Get up and anoint him. This is the one.
Even though God had promised David would be king, though, David spent years on the run from King Saul, fearing for his life. Still, he chose to trust God.
The Lord is my shepherd. He gives me everything I need.
Now, none of these people in the Old Testament could see with their eyes how God was going to save his people, but they could see how he was working in their lives, how their needs were being met. So they chose to believe in his greater plan. They chose faith.
Faith is being sure of what we hope for. It is being sure of what we do not see. That is what the people of long ago were praised for.
Now, here's where the story turns. In Hebrews, we discover that none of those people in the Old Testament received what God had promised here on earth.
That's because God had planned something better for us, so they would only be made perfect together with us.
God's plan includes all of us from the very beginning of creation. So at just the right moment, at the perfect point in time, God sent his rescuer, the hero, his very own son, Jesus. Jesus showed us how to live. He showed us what God was like, and he told us the most important thing.
If you love one another, everyone will know you are my disciples.
Love God, love others. It's the heart of the whole story. But then, Jesus was killed, and his friends thought the story was finished. Period. Dot. The end. Until God raised him back to life. Jesus has defeated death, and those who follow him can live with him forever. But how do you follow someone you can't see? Well, that brings us back to faith.
Let us keep looking to Jesus. He is the one who started this journey of faith, and he is the one who completes this journey of faith. He paid no attention to the shame of the cross. He suffered there because of the joy he was looking forward to. So think about him. Then you won't lose hope.
The early believers, Peter and John and other followers of Jesus, had seen him teach and heal. They saw him after God raised him to life. But after Jesus returned to heaven, the believers continued to live by faith.
We have to speak about the things we've seen and heard.
Because of what the new Christians in the early church had seen, they could believe in what they could not yet see, the end of the story, where God makes everything right. They kept the faith, and because they did, we can choose faith too.
Abraham, Moses, David, Peter, and John, they all believed in something that they couldn't see. Let's look at how the author of Hebrews puts it. If we look at Hebrews chapter 11, verses 39 and 40, it says, "All these people were praised because they had faith, but none of them received what God had promised. That's because God had planned something better for us." So again, just like last week, if we were all together here in this room, this is the time that I would say, who can tell me what that something was that God had promised? So I will call on a couple of our Crosspoint kids again. So Dominic and Jonathan, what is that something that God had promised us?
Jesus!
That is exactly right. You see, Abraham, Moses, and David, the three examples from the Old Testament, they couldn't see God's big plan. They couldn't see the end of the story. They didn't know who Jesus was, God's rescuer, his only son that he sent for us to give us eternal life. They didn't know that. They couldn't see that. They only had the scriptures to go off of, and they had to lean on faith that God would indeed send his son. Now, we have the New Testament. We have the scriptures about Jesus Christ, the Gospels of Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John that tell us about Jesus' life, and we have all those words that we can turn to and lean on. And that is why our bottom line today is you can know Jesus even though you've never seen him. I love that this doesn't say you can believe in Jesus. It doesn't say you can read about Jesus. It says you can know Jesus even though you've never seen him. The people of the Old Testament, their bottom line probably would have been, you can know God even though you've never seen him, because Jesus hadn't walked the earth yet. Jesus hadn't come yet. But now we have Jesus. We have this. We have our Bible that we can turn to and use to read about Jesus, to not only understand him and think of him as a figure in history, but we can know him. We can have a relationship with him. When these binoculars are no good to us, let's remember that God gives us the Bible. He gives us people in our life. He does give us things that we can see to know who Jesus is. It requires faith. It requires digging deep inside of yourself and saying, I am going to 100% know who Jesus is. I'm not just going to try to understand why he came and why God sent him. I'm going to know him and have a relationship with him. So to try to put this in the context of, you know, what we're going through today, things are very out of focus. Things are blurry. You know, we have a lot of questions, at least I do, about what direction life is headed. But God is so good to us. God gave us his son Jesus, and Jesus taught us to love one another. Jesus' greatest commandment was, love the Lord your God with all your heart and love your neighbor as yourself. Love is the answer. Let's remember that today. When things are out of focus, when things are blurry, when things seem distant and out of our control, we can pick up the binoculars that God gives us, our Bible, and we can take a closer look at what we can do to make the situation better. We can just love each other the way that Jesus calls us to love each other. So you might be thinking to yourself right now, where do I start with all of this? Where do I start in terms of putting my faith in Jesus and getting to know who He is? You might be thinking to yourself, Mr. Jeff, this all sounds great, but man, the Bible's a big book. I can't just read it overnight. There's a lot in there that's confusing to me. I get that. I know that. I can relate to that. There's times when I get overwhelmed also, and I just think, gosh, this is too big. This is too much information. How do I take it all in? I'm not worthy of all of this. I can relate to those feelings, but start by talking to somebody that you trust. Maybe a parent or a sibling or a friend from church who also might be trying to figure out how to know Jesus better, and have that walk together. Jesus calls us to have fellowship together and learn about Him together, and it can help so much. It's one of the reasons why I can't wait to be back together with you again so we can start this walk again together and continue learning as a group in person. But until then, talk to somebody in your life about how you can get to know Jesus better and talk to Him. He, Jesus, will point you in the right direction. Focus on our memory verses. Focus on the verses of the day. If you have a Bible app, or if your parents have a Bible app, they can share with you a verse of the day. These are things that we can do to start getting to know who Jesus is better. So guys, when things seem out of focus, when you're confused and not sure where to turn, my best advice for you right now is just to love each other. Love your neighbor as Jesus wants us to. Love your God. Give Him praise. Give Him glory. And just find some peace and love in your heart for those around you. And if we all do that, if we all have love, if we all can focus on our faith in Jesus Christ and remember that His greatest commandment was to love God and to love each other as ourselves, we're going to win. So I encourage you to do that today. Let's spend some time right now worshiping God together. Let's give Him some praise and the glory that He deserves.
Let's pray together.
Thank you for your word in the Bible.
Thank you
for making us.
And you rose from the dead.
You did rise from the dead. And Jesus, thank you that we can trust you. God, help us to trust you when we're afraid, when we don't see the answers, and we don't know what's going to happen. Father, thank you for all of those people in the Bible who were faithful. Lord, we can look and see chapter after chapter of people who stood strong in you. Father, help us to be like that. Help us to be faith-filled. Help us to look to you in all things. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Quack. Quack. Nothing. Well, Crosspoint kids, hope you enjoyed this lesson today. Over the next 7 weeks, we're going to continue talking about what it means to trust in the things that you can't see by leaning on the things that we can see. I'm going to get back to some bird watching. I can't wait to see you soon. Have a great week, guys.